QR codes can be used anywhere in Amazon Fresh's shopping cart. A QR code is used to link the user's Amazon account. Also, all coupons issued by Amazon Fresh are QR codes. After shopping, proceed with payment on the spot. Very convenient. This is a QR code maker that is very easy to make a QR code right away. Because it works as a standalone, no internet connection is required. When you enter any string you want, a QR code is created and displayed on the screen. That's it. This is how it works. If you look at this with your smartphone camera, it decodes the QR code and shows the string inside it. If it's a URL, you can also go directly to the website. I'm running a simple OpenCV project that can recognize QR codes on my Raspberry Pi 02W. When the QR code is shown in front of the USB camera, the data of the QR code is decoded and the data is displayed on the screen. It works very well. This time, let's update it to Hello World. It's impressive to quickly detect QR codes from incoming images, even if it's just the raw performance of the Raspberry Pi board. I hope to work on the Raspberry Pi project together sooner or later. Anyway, this is the QR code maker that I will share with you today. What makes this so simple is LVGL. LVGL not only has a virtual keyboard but also includes a library for creating a QR code. That's awesome. All you need for a QR code is these three lines. It's designed to be very easy to use. So a single page application is simply possible using this. This project is using LVGL version 8. You must use LVGL version 8 to try my code because it's not backward compatible. In order to run my project, there are some things that need to be modified in the LV config header file first. First, enable the QR code library. And since it used the font Monsterhead 34, we need to enable it or change the font in the code. This completes the setting of the LVGL config. One more thing is that since I use a dark theme, it's recommended to change the default theme to the dark theme if you want to get the same colors as mine. Well, we have all different types of the displays, so the display settings must be done individually. If you use TFT SPI, just remove the My Display header file. It's using RavianGFX. Since I'm using WT32SC01 product, I have set the display settings accordingly. This single page application is a basic example. From top, image widget for my logo image, a label widget to display the text QR code maker, text area widget to receive text input, and keyboard. This is all. If it gets the string input by the user into a QR code object, you can get a QR code right away. Please review my code and you'll see how simple it is. If you have any questions about my code, please leave a comment below this video. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.